आई एम डॉक्टर संतोष अग्रवाल, सुशीला नेत्रालय औरंगाबाद। आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द वीडियो ऑन फेको इमल्सिफिकेशन इन ए यूवियाइटिक कैटरैक केस, कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कैटरैक विथ स्मॉल प्यूपिल। दिस इज 2.8 क्लियर कॉर्नल इंसिजन, हाई मॉलिकुलर विस्को इज यूटिलाइज्ड टू मेंटेन द एंट्री चेम्बर, हैविंग गुड डेप्थ ऑफ द एंट्री चेम्बर एंड टू डायलेट द प्यूपिल एज मच पॉसिबल। दिस इज द साइड पोर्ट इंसिजन, टू साइड पोर्ट 180 डिग्री अपार्ट। एज यू नो द प्यूपिल इज नॉट वेल डायलेटेड इन केस ऑफ यूवेटिक कैटरक केसेस, इट्स अ सेक्लूसिव प्यूपिली, पेशेंट इज अ यंग मेल ऑफ अराउंड 40 ईयर्स ओल्ड, हैविंग अंकोलॉजिंग स्पॉन्डिलाइटिस, रिकरेंट यूवेटिस, विट्राइटिस, लीडिंग टू कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कैटरैक। पेशेंट हैड वंस एक्यूट ग्लोकोमा एंड याग आयरिडोटॉमी वॉज डन। नाउ वी आर ट्राइंग टू सेपरेट द प्यूपिलरी बॉर्डर फ्रॉम द कैप्सूल। द एडिजन्स वी आर गोइंग टू ब्रेक एज देर इज ए हेपोटोनी, एंड ऑल्सो टू मेंटेन द एंट्री चेम्बर डेप्थ फॉर द मैनिपुलेशंस। एंट्री चेम्बर मेंटेनर इज अप्लाइड। नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ आयरिस रिपोजिटर वी ट्राई टू सेपरेट द प्यूपिलरी बॉर्डर फ्रॉम द कैप्सूल। क्रिसेंट नाइफ इज ऑल्सो यूज टू ब्रेक द साइनिकिया एज इट वॉज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मेक द स्पेस बिटवीन द आयरिस टिश्यू एंड द कैप्सूल। 360 डिग्री वी हैव सेपरेटेड द प्यूपिलरी एज फ्रॉम द कैप्सूल, एडिजन्स वेर ब्रोकन। Now we are going to remove the membrane which are present at the pupillary border so that we can get adequate pupillary dilatation. They are very thin membranes. Now you can see little bit dilatation is achieved. Uterata forceps is used, or you can use any vitreous forceps to separate or take out such type of membranes. We respected the iris tissue as much possible because we know it can get inflamed postoperatively, and the very aim of the surgery is in vain. Now instead of stretching the pupil, we thought of doing the sphincterotomy so that we can have adequate capsulorhexis. Now it's a white cataract, so we have used trypan blue to stain the entry capsule. Again, high molecular weight viscoat was used to dilate the pupil and also to protect the corneal endothelium. AC maintainer was used to for the adequate depth of the entry chamber, which pour the visco 2% HPMC as and when necessary to protect the corneal endothelium as well as to maintain the entry chamber. So visco filled syringe is applied to the AC maintainer. Now we are doing the capsulorhexis. As the capsule is very fragile, at places it is thick also and calcified. So in such cases, we have to do the things very delicately. We have to respect the iris tissue as much possible, so that in order to reduce the postoperative inflammation, adhesion, synechia, glaucoma and other complications. To have good outcome, intraoperative manipulation should be minimized. Now this is the curved cannula which is used to make the heterodissection. In multiple quadrants we have done the heterodissection. As the cataract is complicated, there are maybe adhesions, and sometimes forcibly if we apply the pressure of the fluid wave, PC can get ruptured. So to avoid that, at multiple sites the heterodissection was performed. Now in the nucleus management, the phaco power was used minimally, and slowly it was removed. As patient is a young chap, the cataract is a soft cataract, but this type of cataract we cannot predict. At places it is calcified, firm, adhesions, all the things we have to take care of. Now this is the cortex removal by the bimanual method, irrigation aspiration, capsular bag is polished, and the cortex is removed in toto, so that in order to reduce the or avoid the postoperative inflammation. Again, the chances of PCO in such cases are very high, so to reduce the chances we have used the polisher. Now the lens is implanted. It is a hydrophobic acrylic IOL. Hydrophilic IOL also, acrylic IOL can be used, one piece IOL. In the back placement is mandatory. Again, subconjunctival dexa-genta was given. So pre-operative we started with the steroids, and again post-operatively aggressively we have to maintain it. Thank you very much.